How's it going, everybody? I'm David from Manolo Ranch. I'm here today to go over a few points on this extra wide frame and the six tier. All right, started. So this here is the extra wide frame. As you can see, it's a lot wider. It's basically from the back of the cage all the way to the tippy top to the front of the egg rollout tray. One thing that I get asked a lot is basically the positioning of the trays and rule of thumb or rule of finger. So let's say you push it in like this, right? That's generally how clients push it in. I say push it back like so, right? Two fingers in the front, two fingers in the back. Like I said, just use your fingers. Doing that allows light to reach the feeder here. As you can see, you know, like this covers it. This allows more light, also protects it from any debris that may or may not fall in. Then we got the trots back here. It ideally does the same, protects any debris that may come in here. Also gives a light. We do have the dust covers if you are in a more dusty or ambient area. That's essentially what I recommend using. You can give me a shout, send me a message, and get a quote ready for you. Meanwhile, we're still updating the site. Now, since it is a six tier, we do have the water troughs on this one. This one has the adjustable float and all, and it just, you know, easy put on and off. Now, another point is that the cages serve two purposes. It's a production cage, of course, but you can also use it as a grow out cage if you want to get them out of your brooder. Keep in mind the weather does play a huge role in that. If it's warmer, you can take them out about 3 to 4 weeks of age. If it's colder, you might want to keep them in the brooder just a bit longer until they're a little more mature. If you're going to keep your cage in a grow out configuration, you're going to want to lower the troughs. So standard, the troughs is up here, and in a grow out configuration, it would be, you know, down here. The same with the feeder, right? So you got your feeder trough here. This is at the point they should be when they're adults, you know, so you can collect your eggs here. And if you're gonna use it as a grow out, you would unhook the feeder, cover the egg rollout tray, and with a rag, I had a rag handy, just put it down there, and it helps keep the feeder up against the cage. That way they can reach the feed and still see it. You know, once they reach their 7 to 8 weeks of age, you would remove this, raise this up here, and start collecting your eggs. So with that being said, the main point of this is the frame. You know, it's a lot wider than the regular frame. Oh, before I get into that, the casters, you know, we have the locking casters here that locks the swivel and the roll. So you just lock it and then just, you know, unlock it and you're good to go. But like I was saying, frame goes from this side to this side, hooks in the middle. If you do have questions, as far as this goes, if you have questions about this, feel free to give me a shout. I'll be more than happy to make any instructional video you need, but the same deal applies. You know, you got your bolts here, bolted on together. This frame was ordered by a customer that orders custom cages with us quite regularly. They wanted a flat surface on it. So they can, I think they were going to put on some sort of tarp or like plastic liner on it to help it with the weather. Don't quote me on that though, but they're the mastermind behind this. So yeah, I just, I'm not sure how sturdy it is. And, you know, basically it. If you have any more questions, feel free to give me a shout, shoot me a text message or an email, and I'll be more than happy to get back to you. Have a nice day.